No, it's actually a common misperception that only physicians work for Doctors Without Borders, but we actually need a comprehensive team of professionals to support our health programs in the field. So that means nurses, epidemiologists, pharmacists, lab technicians, and also from a non-medical point of view, we need logisticians and administrators. Logisticians do many things in the field. We need construction specialists, people who are going to build the hall structures that we work out of. We need electricians, so people who can keep the electricity and our generators running properly. We need mechanics, those that can fix the vehicles that we use to get to our projects. And finally, supply specialists. We have to make ensure that we can get medical supplies to and from the field. And so those supply experts really help to make that process happen smoothly. Administrators do the bookkeeping, accounting, financial planning, pay the bills for the project, and also do all of the HR management for our teams in the field. So we're looking for people who can be flexible and adaptable. And by flexible, we mean people that aren't afraid of things changing. So often in the field, you may be confronted with a disease that you haven't seen before, or an outbreak that you might have to address, or violence might erupt in the community that you're working. And so you have to be flexible enough to adapt to the realities and to treat what the patients need. In the US, often you have specialists that you can refer patients to, but in the field, you don't always have that luxury. And so often you may have to work outside your normal comfort zone or scope of practice here in the US. In addition, we have over 140 nationalities that work for us in the field. So we really want people who are adaptable to work in a multicultural setting. But there are other things that are really helpful to have before you come to the organization. One is language aptitude. So knowledge of French and increasingly Arabic. Management experience, because often in the field you're going to be managing large teams. Also professional experience, so we want people to come to us already having a professional background in place. So for physicians, that means completion of residency. For everyone else, it means 2 years of relevant work experience. And finally, we want people who have already traveled so that they've been uncomfortable before. So when they get to the field, they're not surprised by the austere conditions in which we work. You cannot choose where you go with Doctors Without Borders. We place people based on the needs of the field and how your skill set meets those needs. So the time commitment is 9 to 12 months for all professionals except for our surgical teams, and that includes our anesthesia providers, our OBGYNs, and our surgeons. For them, it's a 2 to 3 month commitment, and the reason why is because normally they're on call 24 hours, 7 days a week, so it's a very much more physically demanding job, so they only go for a shorter period of time. MSF will pay for your flights, your accommodations, visas, transportation to and from the field, and we provide a small monthly stipend that goes directly into your US bank account here. If you think you have what it takes to work with us, please go to doctorswithoutborders.org, work with us, and apply.